My name is Emily Parrish. I'm a senior, and I'm majoring in government and religious studies.
Our coach told us about Friends of Jacqueline, which is an organization where children either struggling with cancer or some sort of terminal illness get matched with a team. So she found Emma. As soon as we met her, her personality was just infectious. She got everyone to love her instantly.
She's one of the most outgoing kids I've ever met. Emma comes to a bunch of our practices, and she'll sort of stand on the side of the gym or the field and yell things at us. She'll tell us to run or do push-ups, and we have to do it because Emma's in charge. We also do things outside of softball. We've gone bowling a few times, which she loves to bowl.
While we do a bunch of different things with Emma, the most important part is that Emma's become a part of our family. People always come up to us and say what a great thing we're doing for Emma. And while that might be true, I think what we've all come to realize is that Emma's doing just a great thing for us.
She's the most inspirational person I know.
She goes through things that I can't even imagine having to deal with.
I get stressed about tests or papers, and then I think about Emma and I realize, like, what matters in life.
I love doing service projects and things like that, but I never thought we could have such an intimate relationship with someone, especially through an athletic sport.
Emma's feels sort of like a little sister to me. I know that our support for her matters a lot, and it keeps her spirits up when she's going through things like chemo and different aspects of her illness.
So I think that it's important to maintain that relationship for her sake, but also for mine. I can't imagine not talking to her at this point.
I can't wait for you guys to see this, and let's have a chocolate party.
Say it one more time. Say it a little bit louder.
They have a chocolate party.
Emma had a surgery coming up, and she couldn't go out trick-or-treating. So on the spur of the moment, Kim and the team decided to throw a Halloween party. And we held it at our house, and they all came over. And the girls all went into different rooms, and Emma trick-or-treated the different rooms in the house. So things like that have been very, very good for us to be able to celebrate the holidays that normally she wouldn't have been able to do